Okay, everyone. So you know how sometimes you just stare at things, maybe space simulations like this, and you start questioning stuff you've always taken for granted? Like the sun. Our sun. Big, bright, warm, pretty standard G-type main sequence star, right? That's what they teach us. That's what all the textbooks say. But what if that's just the convenience story? What if the reality is actually stranger? And maybe, just maybe, hidden in plain sight. I was looking into some astronomical oddities, some weird data points, and fell down a bit of a rabbit hole. And it led me to this. PSR J2144-33. Now, PSR J2144-3933 isn't a normal star. It's a pulsar, a neutron star, actually. The super dense remnant left over after a massive star went supernova billions of years ago. And the rabbit hole I fell down, well, it started to suggest something pretty wild. What if that is actually our sun? I know, sounds completely nuts. Pulsars are famous for lighthouse-like beams of intense radiation, spinning incredibly fast. How could life possibly exist around that? Well, J2144 is different. It's famously slow for a pulsar, one of the slowest ever found. It rotates once every 8.5 seconds, and it's also unusually cool for a neutron star. Okay, so first big question. If it's a pulsar, where does the light and heat come from? Pulsars don't glow like our sun does from fusion, but they do have unbelievably strong magnetic fields and emit powerful stellar winds, streams of charged particles. What if the light and heat we get isn't direct? What if it's the result of this intense particle wind interacting with the planet's own magnetic fields and atmospheres? A kind of induced glow and warmth, strongest on the side facing the pulsar. Think about it. Mercury, it's a scorched, airless rock anyway. Maybe its density and weak magnetic field are just enough to barely survive the bombardment, constantly getting blasted, but holding together. Venus, with its ridiculously thick atmosphere and runaway greenhouse effect, perhaps that thick blanket is the perfect shield, absorbing and reprocessing the pulsar's energy in its own chaotic way. And Earth, our strong dynamic magnetic field. We see the evidence of particle interaction all the time with the auroras. What if the magnetosphere is doing way more work than we realize, deflecting the most harmful stuff and channeling the rest? Maybe our atmosphere's specific composition interacts with the pulsar wind in just the right way to create the visible light spectrum we see and trap enough energy for liquid water. It would explain why our magnetic field is so crucial. Mars is trickier. Thin atmosphere, weak field. Maybe its distance is just enough. In its past, thicker atmosphere was when life might have had a chance. And the gas giants? Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune? They're huge, far out, and possess incredibly powerful magnetic fields of their own. Jupiter's magnetosphere is enormous. They could easily handle the particle wind, maybe even capture some of that energy, contributing to their internal heat sources and complex atmospheric dynamics. They wouldn't rely on gentle sunlight. They'd be interacting directly with the raw power of the pulsar wind, shielded by distance and magnetism. The key is J2144's specific properties. It's old. Its spin has slowed dramatically. Its energy output, while still immense by human standards, might be low for a pulsar. Maybe its rotational axis and magnetic axis are aligned in such a way that the most intense radiation beams just miss the planetary plane. It's a lot of maybes, but when you look at this specific object, it's almost plausible. It elegantly explains why our sun seems to have such a powerful magnetic field influence throughout the system, perhaps more than a simple G-type star should. It really changes how you view everything, doesn't it? Our entire existence, balanced precariously around this ancient, spinning stellar corpse, mistaking its energetic whispers for the gentle warmth of a normal star. All the physics, all the biology, predicated on this fundamentally different kind of central object, or, you know, maybe not. Hope you enjoyed that little thought experiment, though. Have a good day. Happy April Fool's Day, everyone.